Today in Afghanistan, obtaining reliable power is a constant challenge. Neighboring countries surrounding Afghanistan currently provide a majority of its power through long-distance, high-voltage power transmission connected to transfer and distribution stations placed near Afghanistan's population centers. Losses associated with long-distance power transmission, however, create inefficiencies and add costs. To ensure a more stable, efficient, and reliable power source, USAID, in partnership with Afghanistan's Ministry of Energy and staff from the country's national power utility, the Afghanistan Breshna Shirkat, known locally as DABS, recently tested and energized three newly installed reactive power capacitor banks at Afghanistan's largest sub-power station, Chimtala.
The people of Afghanistan, especially the people of Kabul city, was very, very afraid and they were not able to get reliable power. Yesterday, we energized this system very successfully. I was here and we understood that this is the best project for Afghanistan.
We see the change. With this cap bank, we will solve a lot of difficulties of power in Kabul city.
Located in North Kabul, Chimtala receives, transmits, and distributes the majority of Afghanistan's imported power. With the connection of the new high-voltage capacitor banks, imported power transfer capacity almost doubled. The system is now far better equipped to provide reliable electricity to industrial, commercial, and private customers.
So by managing of good voltage and good power factor, exactly the distribution situation will be much better than before, and the people will be happy. It is very reliable and very useful for industrial area.
The long-distance power lines from Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan create inevitable power losses evidenced in high-voltage irregularities. The new capacitor banks allow better voltage level control, resulting in a far more stable power flow.
Before, the efficiency of power was very low.
DAPS was not able to import more than 140 megawatts power to Kabul. By energization of this project, the capability of line is going up. DAPS will be able to import around 260 to 280 megawatts import power from Uzbekistan.
Now I'm very happy that after 3 years hard working, I was able to see the energization of my project and the completion of my project.
Families, business owners, schools and hospitals, citizens across Kabul and northern Afghanistan now enjoy the benefits of electricity. But all of the challenges are not yet solved. USAID knows that as Afghanistan continues to develop, the demand for power will only increase. To better prepare for future growth, USAID has trained DAB staff to operate and maintain these new systems. These skilled and competent Afghan technicians will be ready to operate a truly national-level grid. At the other reactive power sites, Kabul North, Nabadad, Guli Kumri, the talented and dedicated DABS professionals who USAID helped train will operate these sites to further illuminate the future of Afghanistan with affordable and reliable power. With support from the American people through the United States Agency for International Development, everyday Afghans are powering their way towards a sustainable and improved quality of life.